Today, I'm going to give you a test. But don't worry. It's not too difficult. It's only one question. And that question is... Assessments are blank. So, is the answer A, a necessary evil? B, pointless? Don't apply to the real world. C, something that is high stakes, forgive the typo, mysterious and stressful. D, an opportunity to review and improve learning. E, a way to see if students are learning what they're supposed to. F, a chance to demonstrate what you've learned in a meaningful way. Or, finally, G, an opportunity to review instructional methods and assessments for their effectiveness. Continuous improvement. So, which one is it? Is it more than one? Can it be all of them? Sometimes. The truth is, which one it will be is completely up to us. We get to decide if our assessments will be A, B, or C. Those don't benefit anyone. Or we can choose for them to be D, E, F, and G. When we do that, we benefit students by being engaging and relevant, providing valuable feedback, and an opportunity to self-evaluate and improve. These benefit instructors by giving them information about the effectiveness of their teaching and instructional materials. And they benefit both instructors and programs by providing data about achievement of learning outcomes. So, how do we make sure that our assessments are doing these and not these? Well, I have 10 things to consider when choosing assessments. Number one, design backwards. Start with your learning outcomes for your course. If they are measurable, then they will dictate your assessments. So, to illustrate these points, I'm going to use a fictional ASVAB ASMR video class. So in this class, my learning objectives are: 1, define ASMR. 2, list common visual and auditory triggers. 3, discuss the benefits of ASMR. 4, evaluate an ASMR video. And 5, create and self-evaluate an ASMR video. Once you have your learning objectives, you want to vary your assessments so that you can assess different levels of learning. And what do we mean by that? Well, that is when we go to our handy Bloom's taxonomy with the levels of learning. If we were to give a multiple choice test that really only measures recall, which is the lowest level of learning, we also want to be able to assess whether students can apply their learning, use it to make connections, and apply what they've learned to create something new. Thus, we assess all levels of learning. Once we have that, then, 3, match assessment level to learning objective level. So let's go back to our learning objectives. 1, define ASMR. 2, list common visual and auditory ASMR triggers. Those two outcomes are at the remember level. So, pretty low level of learning. We could assess this with a short answer test that asks students to recall information that they've learned. The third learning outcome: discuss the benefits of ASMR, is at the understand level. A short paper might be a good way to assess this. The fourth learning outcome: evaluate an ASMR video, is at the analyze and evaluate levels. Assessing this outcome would require an assignment in which students would need to watch an ASMR video and write an analysis based on defined criteria. The fifth learning outcome: create and self-evaluate an ASMR video, is at the evaluate and create levels. This would be assessed by having the student create a video based on everything they had learned, and then complete a self-evaluation based on defined criteria. Okay. 4. Do all course materials support the objectives and assessments? You wouldn't want to assess something that you've never taught. Define ASMR. Excuse me, teacher. Did we go over this? So, if one of the outcomes is to list common auditory and visual ASMR triggers, then we'd want to make sure that we were reviewing them, such as some common audio triggers, such as tapping, ear to ear whispers, unique and interesting sounds, something like this could also be an interesting visual trigger as well. Something that could be, again, both visual and auditory, like hair brushing. We would need make sure that we have covered all of these things before assessing them. At the same time, we want to make sure that we're not including something that's unrelated to the learning outcomes and assessments. This Stranger Things 2 fan theory is really great. I'm going to add it to my class assignments this week. Number 5, make your assessments authentic. If you're taking a class like this one on ASMR videos, would you make the assessments entirely multiple choice tests? What good is that going to do anyone? That's not an authentic assessment. Assessments in which students make ASMR videos is an authentic assessment because it mirrors real-world application. 6. Pay attention to validity and reliability. If you followed number 1, then you could be pretty confident that your assessments have validity and are measuring what you want them to measure. Assessments need to measure the same each time to have reliability. Our learning objectives might have different interpretations based on who is doing the grading. So how do we make sure they're reliable? This leads us to number 7. Rubrics. Everyone's favorite. Rubrics. How do we use them? 1. Make them clear and simple. Use language appropriate for students' level. Use parallel language between performance levels in each category. So, we might have a rubric for the assignment to create an ASMR video in which we score based on audio, video, triggers, and creativity. And each level of performance has its own indicator. That way, anyone who is using this rubric should rate an assignment the same. Number eight, use lots and lots of formative assessment with good feedback. So, we want to use the formative assessments to be checkpoints during the class. Students get to use the feedback to improve and can learn from their mistakes. Teachers can see how everyone is doing and make course corrections if necessary. Okay, now here is my final project, my ASMR video. Try again. 9. Use your rubrics in formative self-assessment. How do we do that? Give the rubric to students beforehand so they know what you expect in the assignment. Give them a chance to grade their own assignments using the rubric and then use it to make revisions. And finally, number 10, portfolios. Portfolios are a great tool to reflect on learning and show progress over time. For this ASMR video class, a portfolio would be your YouTube channel in which you could see your improvement from the first video to your latest video. These concepts will make your course exciting and engaging and set the stage for active learning and meeting learning objectives. Now, go out there and assess yourself so that you can assess